One Shaper 1000 here. Today we're going to pull the head off this Evinrude. This is off of our personal boat. Last couple times we took it out, it seemed like it was losing power. Well, today it was the same way. It was really hard to start, and then it just started. I think it was running on one cylinder. But we're going to pull the head off and check that out. It could be, you know, the exhaust clogged. I'm not sure. But we're going to go ahead and pull this head off, see what we find inside there. Hopefully it's not scored or anything like that. Okay, so this is real easy. Take the heads off of these things. It's just a 13 millimeter. Head gaskets for this thing's only like $13. I'm not sure if that's the issue or not, but we're going to find out what's going on with it. That's why I wanted to get the Scott Atwater running and put on here so we can so I can totally rebuild this motor, and if we wanted to go boating, we could still go boating. But I'm having a problem finding a coil for that thing. So I'm gonna go ahead and get these bolts out, and I'll bring you back when I'm ready to pop this head off of here. Alright guys, so I got all the bolts out, well, except for three of them broke, which I was kind of expecting that, but I didn't want it. But you get dealing with these old boat motors, got a wooden mallet here, but it doesn't seem to be doing anything, so I don't want to use metal on it, but I guess I'm going to have to. I can't find my rubber or my plastic dead blow. Let me go see if I can find it. Okay, I couldn't find it, so I'm just going to have to go easy. And it's not wanting to come off, so it's not even budging. What it is, it's stuck on these bolts that didn't want to come out. So I'm going to keep tapping on this. Hopefully we can get it to come out of there. Pretty sure I can get the bolts out after I get that head off, but I gotta get the head off first, so let me keep tapping on this. Alright, I got you on a different angle. That tapping thing, nah, that went out the window. Sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do, so unfortunately I'm not gonna be able to. I might still be able to tell if the gasket's blown or not, but what it was the bolts were stuck onto the heads, or stuck onto the head, so sometimes you got to do what you got to do. And you know, it's just all part of it. You're not supposed to do this, but I mean, sometimes you got to do it. Yes, I did try to heat the head up some, but there's the head. Pull this gasket off here and see what we can see. This is where I was messing with it. Oh, excuse me. So, I think, yeah, a lot of movement there. Never ran a compression test on it. I know the compression's low. And I do see some scoring down in here. I'll show you that if I can. Oops. May have to go get a light. But right here. Yep, there's some scoring in there. I mean, I can't feel it, but that's telling me there's an issue there. So, I thought I heard a wrist pin slapping. There is some water in here. So, there could have been a head gasket issue at one time. I know for a fact this thing was running hot because he told me. I can still see cross hatchings in that cylinder down to bottom. So, but I know this thing's never been apart before, so I don't think it's got that many hours, but there is some scoring right there, and that can cause a loss of compression. So, it's looking like I'm going to be pulling this power unit off. What it is just, really, think of it as your lower unit as your transmission, this as your motor. So what I'm probably going to have to do is I'm going to have to pull this off of here, the motor off, and tear into it and rebuild it. I think I can get these studs out of here now. See, that one's loose. Well, they were all loose, but they come so far and stop, and then when I went to tighten them back up, they stopped again. But I think, you know, I'm pretty sure I can get these out. I think mostly from where they're snapped off at, they're snapped off up here, not in there. Usually if they're stuck in the head part, they'll snap off there. So hopefully, and as hard as that head was to get off of there, I think maybe it was just stuck into the head area. So yeah, hopefully those will come out. Yeah, you know, I'll probably put a new head on it too. I kind of scuffed that up. I can have this head milled, but I ain't even gonna mess with it now. It's like I said, you know, it is what it is. Sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do to get things apart, because really it's doing us no good right now. It was missing, so, you know, I mean, it was just chugging, and I thought it was only running on one cylinder, but it might have been running on two. It just, one cylinder had less compression. Probably should have done a compression test, but even if I did, I would have still been pulling this head off. So I just skipped that step, pulled the head. So I'm guessing this head might have been warped, because like I said, I know it was run hot, as he told me, overheated it. So I'm guessing the head was warped. I'm not seeing where it was blown, but there is some water in there. I was getting some water in there from somewhere. So yeah, well, guess I'll order some rings for it and a head. I could probably have that head milled down, but I think I'll just go ahead and get a new head. This I can clean up myself, I think. I believe so. Yeah, this is pretty good shape up here, this part. So, all right, so that's what we're looking at that. So, there you go. We pulled the head off. Sorry I didn't bring you with me when I was banging on it, but that's all I was doing was hitting it back and forth. Back and forth. And there's some spots, like down here. It's made to put, you know, the tap on. As you can see, it was getting thin there. There's another one over here. There's one up here at the top. I did beat on it a little bit there, up here. But so, yeah, I think that's what I'll do. I'll just go ahead and rebuild this whole engine. So I'm just checking ahead. I'm looking for cracks. Just to... But see, this head goes on like this. So, right there is a water jacket. Doesn't look like it was getting in there, but it could have very well been. The way that looks inside of there. But I did see some water droplets in there. So, okay, guys, so that's what we're going to do. I'm going to see about ordering some parts here next couple days, and I'll bring you along with me when I take this head unit or this power unit off, and we'll take the pistons out. I'll probably wait to order any parts until I get it tore down, because, you know, I want to know how the pistons are, you know, if they're scored or whatnot. These are called high dome pistons. I think that's a slap I was hearing. Okay. Well, I'm not gonna get to it tonight, so, damn it. But I will get to it, and we'll go from there, so. That being said, I'm going to say stay bare the myth, the man, the legend. I'm gone for now. I'm going to pick up my tools, and we'll see you guys in the next one. Thanks for joining me, guys. I appreciate it. Don't forget to check out Monkey 1000's channel. And we'll see you next one. Bye-bye.